against you. Jeremiah said in Jeremiah 2 verse 19, says your own wickedness will correct you. Your own backslidings will rebuke you. Know therefore and see that it is an evil and bitter thing that you have forsaken the Lord your God. And the fear of God is not in you, says the Lord God of hosts. When are you going to fear God, man? When are you going to understand that Jesus Christ holding back judgment upon your life, that you have another day, that you have another opportunity, that you might receive mercy for all these sins that you have heaped up to yourself?
I'm gay.
When are you going to, yeah.
Do you accept me?
I wish you were gay, mean, and happy.
No, I am homosexual.
Okay. You're not happy, though.
I'm very happy.
Well, the Bible says no peace for the wicked.
No,
you can't have fulfillment.
I can't be homosexual.
Well, let me tell you, Colossians 2 says in him we are complete.
So
who is him? Jesus Christ. Are you in Christ as a homosexual?
Oh.
I'm just curious. Do you think so?
Am I in Christ?
Yeah, do you think you're in Christ?
Hell no.
No, okay, well that's good that you believe. The Bible says in Christ we're complete.
So if
we're
I'm
not complete without Christ. I'm just telling what the Bible says. Yeah, well, in Christ.
We're dealing with this, what the Bible says.
Yeah, if you're not in Christ, you're not complete.
So what you're saying is, if I'm a can I talk?
What do you want to say?
I want to say exactly what I'm saying.
Well, this woman has something she wants to share with you guys. She's a homosexual woman, but she's not gay.
Oh, I'm totally gay.
No, you're not happy. Gay means happy.
Oh, so.
They took that word and changed it. Go ahead, though. What do you want to say?
So if I'm a homosexual, I'm very happy. Very happy, very gay. Am I accepted?
But she's not fulfilled. She's not fulfilled as a homosexual.
I'm not fulfilled?
Yeah, no, I'll tell you, the Bible says that you're not fulfilled.
I'm not accepted.
Well, I'm trying to tell you, it says in him, in Jesus Christ, we are complete, who is the head of the body, the principality and power. How can you be complete without Jesus?
Question.
Because you're going to die. You're going to be judged by God. Go ahead.
Question. So God accepts everyone, right?
No.
God does not accept everyone.
No, the Bible says that outside of the dogs, the sexually immoral.
No. Yes or no? Am I accepted because I'm gay?
The Bible says that you will not be accepted into God's kingdom on the day you die.
Woo!
But here's the good news for this woman.
Motherfucker!
Here's the good news for the homosexuals, okay? The Bible made a way for you to be an ex-homo.
Oh.
A homo nomo. Okay?
Oh! Tell me how to be a homo nomo.
Born again. The Bible says if any man's in Christ, this woman, now thankfully this woman, when she came up to me, she admitted that she's not a Christian. Okay, she is not of Christ. She's not. Some homosexuals think they're Christians. Did you know that?
Yeah, that's terrible.
So what? I don't know. Where are you getting that from? It's not the Bible. The Bible says a man cannot serve two masters. You know, love the one or hate the other. Look, this woman knows she's not a Christian. She is being honest with herself and God. But the Bible says when she becomes a Christian, okay, and I believe, I'm hoping that you become a Christian. The Bible says if any man is in Christ, they're a new creation. What do you want to say?
I'm going to tell you right now, I will never be a Christian.
You don't make up the rules. Your life's not your own. What if God strikes you with something and changes your mind, okay? Isn't that the potter of power over the clay? Look, you think you're so strong right now. I'm a strong homosexual woman. But what if God deals with you and shows you that you're headed to hell?
Has it happened? I've lived 30 years. I haven't been struck down yet.
I heard a little trembling in your voice there. I tell you, don't test the Lord, man. Something bad could happen to you.
Yeah.
And then God can show you need a husband.
I have a husband. He's right over there.
You have a husband and a wife? I thought you said you were homosexual. Or you're a guy.
So I've got
I can't tell you. You look like a woman.
Yeah.
Okay. Why'd you say you have a husband? She's your husband?
I got a little bit of both. I got a little husband and a little wife.
Okay.
How do you feel about that?
And we're brother and sister.
Okay. So you got more issues here, okay, than just the homosexuality.
So let me tell you. So am I going to hell? Am I going to hell because I have a husband and a wife?
Fortunately, as of right now, your destiny is open, okay? You do not have to go to hell. You right now are a candidate for God's mercy. Jesus Christ came to save what was lost. Jesus Christ came to call sinners to repentance. Now, this woman over here, she left, I think she went down the last light. She said that homosexuals can be Christians. She is lying to you, okay? When you become a Christian, you will be an ex-homosexual.
So, what if I'm never a Christian? And I'm a homosexual? And I love women. I love women. And I love men. Now what?
Okay, the Bible says, it says that... It says in Revelation chapter 22, verse 11, it says, let him who was unjust be unjust still.
22,
let him who was,
11.
She remembers. Okay, so let him who was filthy be filthy still. Let him who was righteous be righteous still. Let him who was holy be holy still. So people who are unrighteous and filthy, now it's not just homosexuals, it's drunkards too. I can smell alcohol. In your sin, you
ooh, yeah.
Hey, there's unrighteous.
Love alcohol.
She loves alcohol because she's a sinner. She needs help. Who's going to love this woman? Who's going to love this woman and tell her that she's going to have liver cancer? Liver cancer.
Cirrhosis
of the liver. Look, folks, I didn't come today. I didn't travel 2,000 miles to see you go to hell, okay? I know that that we all deserve hell. We all deserve to go to hell. We all deserve judgment. The wages of sin is death.
Hey.
But the gift of God is eternal life. Will you receive the gift or will you receive AIDS?
AIDS? Oh, fuck. Really?
Well, that's what you can get. Aren't God's judgments in the earth against homosexuals? They're depressed.
Tell me about my pathway to hell. What's it going to be like?
Okay. The Bible says it's a slippery slope, okay?
Mm-hmm.
It's a slippery slope. It gets worse. Evil men and imposters will grow worse and worse, deceived and being deceived. Okay? I'm here today because I don't want you to be deceived by you know, you're being deceived by these homosexuals. Maybe you were a straight woman, but then you saw a lesbian porn.
Homosexual.
That's what happens. They look at pornography on the internet. Woman, when are you going to wake up to fear God? See, you need to fear God, sir. You're going to die, stay before God, and Jesus Christ, he has the authority of the Father. He says if you get in or not. Now, I'm here today, I'm an agent of God, a messenger of God. I don't want you to go to hell. I desire that you be like me and be a Christian. Now, I was a pot smoker, okay?
Shit. You're going to hell, right?
I was a pot smoker. I was a drunkard.
You're going to hell. Let's go.
We're all going to hell together.
Oh, folks. Hey, what is it going to be? What's it going to be for you, ma'am? I care for your soul. Give me your name so I can pray for you.
Last question.
I want to pray for you, ma'am. I don't want you to perish.
Last question.
Go ahead.
God is all good, right?
God is good, yeah.
Why should I fear him?
Because he's good. Because he will not let transgressors into his kingdom. He will not let what is unholy and unrighteous and disgusting. Mm-hmm. Anal sex is disgusting, okay? Anal sex is disgusting. Think about it for a minute. Homosexuals? Anal sex is disgusting. It's vile. God will not let those things in heaven. He's good. But he will change you. He will give you a new heart. He will give you a new path. What do you want? Make it good. Make it good. Don't cuss or anything.
I would never cuss. Anal sex all the way. Yeah!
Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Out of the abundance of the heart, this woman does not understand the delusion that she is under. She has been deceived by the devil. Now I have come here today to bring light into that darkness.
God,
she might see.
God.
What is it?
Look up.
What about God? He's everywhere. He's right here, man. You don't need to look up. He's right here amongst us.
Look up.
You're living and moving and have your being in God, sir.
You're not.
Why aren't you serving God? What are you serving? What are you serving today? Your lusts? Your addictions? God can deliver you from those things. He came to deliver the captives. I was an alcoholic. I know what it's like to be a slave. I know what it's like to be a drug user and be stuck. I was addicted to pornography. I was addicted. I could not stop. I had God at mercy on me. I cried out to God. I started magnifying Jesus, you see?
I was a murderer.
Bible says, hey, man. Jesus even said, when you hate in your heart, that's murder in your heart. See, none of us deserve to go to heaven. I'm here today to tell you about what Jesus did so that you and I might enter in. No one's getting in without Jesus. See, Jesus Christ had to die for us. Jesus Christ was murdered. Jesus Christ was killed. Jesus Christ, who is King. Jesus Christ had to show us how to love. He said in John 15, he said, this is my commandment that you would love as I have loved you. How did Jesus Christ love us? He died for us. People are living in sin, not loving God. You're not loving God when you live in sin. The Bible says you're God-hating. You're a sin-loving God-hater. You need to be a sin-hating God-lover.
Amen.
Amen. Are you a sinner? Are you a sinner? It's not the Bible. Bible doesn't say sinner saved by grace. Bible says you're a new creation.
We're a new creation in Christ.
Amen. No longer a sinner.
He that is in us,
than he that is in the world. 1 John 4:4.
No weapon formed against
you shall prosper. Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes, I love that. That's what you got to
do. Hallelujah. I do missions in Turkey. Go into all the world and preach the gospel.
Good. But don't be a sinner. Don't be a sinner. Okay.
See.
Praise God. Bless you. Bless you. Bless you. I'm Adam.
Hey, Adam.
Praise God. Amen. Keep doing your work on the evangelist. He's coming soon. And press into the kingdom, right?
Amen.
The Bible says that not that I've already attained, or I'm already perfected, but I press on that I may lay hold of that for which Christ Jesus laid hold of me. You see, a lot of people have stopped pressing on. They have stopped pressing into God's kingdom. They have stopped pursuing God. They are coming short. They're not being diligent to present themselves approved unto God. So we come today to stir up your ready minds by way of reminder. Yes, it is good that we would remind you of the coming judgment when God's going to destroy America. God's going to destroy Times Square. Did you know that? God is going to destroy the Big Apple when he destroys the nations that have forgotten God. The Bible says so. The Bible says that God will destroy the nations that have forgotten God. Folks, don't be destroyed with it. Don't have your heart be in the Big Apple in New York City, New York. Oh, man, people have idolatry because of this city. On that day, though, on that day when God has his way in the whirlwind and in the storm, when God has an earthquake that splits the sea, it splits and destroys these cities and the buildings come tumbling down. I'm not talking about 9/11 with planes hitting the buildings. All this comes from within, this judgment. Yes, the Bible says, it says the earth will rise up against them. It says it will split open and swallow them up, the Bible says. The earth will reel to and fro like a drunkard. The earth itself will rise up against because its transgression shall be heavy upon it. The transgression of the earth, the transgression of sinners will be together. Folks, don't go down to the pit. I'm here to tell you, Jesus Christ will raise you up. We'll meet him in the air, it says. You can meet with Jesus in the air. You can fly away and be at rest. Ha! Praise God for the angels. Ministering spirits. You got evil spirits because of drugs. You got evil spirits because of porn. You got evil spirits because of drunkenness. God wants to give you a Holy Spirit in your life. The Holy Spirit. Oh, man, Jesus Christ. He can give it. He can do it. He can do all things well in your life. We were just singing it earlier. He does all things well. Praise God for the work. Yeah. I magnify the work of Christ, so all my trust is in. I don't trust in my money. I don't trust in my intellect. I don't trust in my degrees. I don't trust in my job. I don't trust in people. My wealth may not be there. My friends may not be there, but Jesus will be there. Jesus will see me through. Jesus will never leave me. Jesus will bring me forth as the light. Jesus will save my soul. Jesus will cleanse my heart. Jesus will give me a new name. Jesus will teach me his path. Jesus will cause me to enter in and partake of the tree of life. Will you have Jesus or will you have judgment? Jesus or judgment today? Choose. Choose what you want. You want judgment? You want to have your good deeds outweigh your bad? Then just reject Christ. Reject the work of Christ. But I tell you what, you make the wrong decision when you do that. You make the wrong decision. Our good deeds don't outweigh our bad deeds. This is not a game, folks. This is not Super Mario Brothers. It's not how well you can play the game, how well you can jump the building. You need Jesus Christ to translate you, take you through the wall, bring down that wall of sin. The middle wall of separation that separates us from God. The transgressions. Yes, the ordinances, the law of God written on your heart. You know you're guilty. You know you cannot attain the righteousness because of your own deeds, your own goodness. You need supernatural goodness. You need Jesus Christ, who is good, who is God in the flesh, who is the Word of God. Oh, yeah, the Word of God. God speaks, the earth trembles. I tremble when I hear God's voice. Do you tremble? Can you hear it? The Bible says that God dwells on high, the family who trembles at his word. Will you tremble God's word? Will you read God's word? Will you treasure the word of God? Will you be obedient? Will you be submissive? Will you be able to understand the truth when you hear it? Do you know the truth when you hear it? Or do you follow lies? You give in to the lie of the woman on the internet. She's going to satisfy you. She will not, that porn star will not satisfy you. She'll make you filthy with the devil. She'll make you filthy with devils. That's what you guys are. You got devils upon devils. You got demons upon demons in your life. And Jesus Christ wants to deliver you. Get that devil out of your heart and life.
Leaving?
Yeah, we're going to take
Do you want to preach, man?
No. I got my meters kind of up.
Okay.
Down on 7th Avenue.
Praise God.
Yeah, we'll be back tomorrow.
Okay. Right. Praise God. We love you guys.
Stay in touch.
It's awesome.
See you tomorrow. I got to blow my nose.
This is great. We're able to use this. Yeah. This is amazing. Yeah. You know, it was like the cops were here and they left.
Yeah.
That's when stuff started happening.
That's it. The whole place is shaking now.
Praise the Lord.
I know.
Awesome.
We needed that.
That's great.
Favor and blessing. Yeah, he's like, I own this city, God says. I'll make a way. You'll see about that ordinance. Man, ye have little faith. I should have prayed more. Oh, praise the Lord, though. Okay, God bless you guys. Safe travels. We love you guys. Thanks for coming.
Yeah.
Amen. Glory.
Oh, praise God. Praise God. You see, he does all things well. He does amazing things. We love our brothers and sisters in Christ. We love them. I'm good. Folks, the Bible says, love the brotherhood, fear God, honor the king, it says. Honor all people. Will you love the brotherhood of God, the people of God? You need to be a child of God. The Bible says there's children of the devil and there's children of God. You see, I was a child of the devil because of my sin, because of my wickedness. But God wants to make you a child of himself. God wants to give you the new life that's in Christ. Yes, it has to come through Christ. Look, it's amazing what Jesus can do for you. I am expectant of amazing things. Some of you who have heard the word of God, that you might open your Bibles, that you might have a good seed that will come into your life. God bless you. Now you need to do the next step and repent. Some of you, you've heard the word of God. Now you need to respond to it. You need to react and give your life to Jesus Christ. Repent of your sins and put all your faith and trust in him and magnify the Lord. See, most of you are not understanding your need for submission to God. The Bible says, submit yourselves to God. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. Draw near unto God and he will draw near unto you. You see, the devil, he's like a roaring lion, prowling around, seeking who he may devour. How is the devil getting into your life, huh? How is he taking hold and taking captive of you? I pray that God would open your eyes and teach you his ways. And the truth would set you free, Jesus said. People are enslaved to their sin, Jesus said. He is sin, is a slave of sin. I know, man. You're a sinner, aren't you? Slave to your sin. Sons of God and disobedience. Oh, man. Oh, man, it's a sad state that you're in without Christ. It's sad. Sorrow has filled your heart. But you'd have godly sorrow. Oh, but if you would but be sorry before your sins. Oh, but you would confess that you're a sinner. Oh, but you confess that it's God who is good. Oh, but you would magnify Jesus Christ who is God. That you would say that you don't deserve life.